Hey, shalom, shalom, salam to salam. This is Wendem Alonso, the Lion of Judah Society. Now, we're about to go into this one more time. Now, we're not defending him, and we're not defending the host of the show. We're just speaking what is. Now, if you want to go into, like, be a smartass about something, then there's always someone that could be a smartass about that same thing. So, you know, it's better to be wise in the sense that, you know, anything we say, whether it be smart or not, we say it in reverence to Jah, because, you know, Jah can flip that on anyone, anytime.
Be politically correct
or correct.
Correct. Like being technical about it, you know.
All right, Donald, you're being a little too general. You need to be more specific, Donald.
Well, he himself needs to be more specific.
You know, quote something. I got an idea. Quote something every Christian would know. Or even non-Christian. You know, something like 2 Corinthians.
Like 2 Corinthians.
That's right. I mean, who hasn't heard of 2 Corinthians?
I hear this is a major theme right here, but 2 Corinthians, right? 2 Corinthians 3:17. That's the whole ballgame. Where the Spirit of the Lord, right? Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. And here there is Liberty College, but Liberty University. But it is so true. You know, when you think, and that's really, is that the one? Is that the one you like?
There is so much wrong with it. You know what I love about this? He doesn't even know how wrong 2 Corinthians sounds, right?
All right, there's so much in this. It may sound wrong, right? Or it may sound wrong, excuse me. But what he's saying isn't technically right itself. Now, who's he preaching to? To Christians. They should know. So, you know, Donald Trump even says, right? Correct me if I'm wrong. I mean, you're the one that's supposed to know. But anyways, going forward to 2 Corinthians. Actually, 2 Corinthians is pretty correct in the sense that it's the second epistle. 2 Corinthians. So it's not necessarily 2 Corinthians. No such thing. And plus, this is in the English. So, you know, ones want to get technical. The second epistle. So it's not 2 Corinthians. So this dude is wrong. You know, if you want to be correct, you're incorrect, not correct. So the second epistle of Paul to the apostle, of Paul the apostle to Corinthians. You know, so he's not correct. He's actually somewhat correct. He didn't specify that he's speaking of the second epistle to Corinthians. Now 3:17, it says, now the Lord is that Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty to think for yourself in the way to serve Jah. To think for yourself in the way to serve the Most High, and in doing so, inevitably, you would learn the way to serve your fellow brothers and sisters within the human community. But many of these ones can't think for themselves. So ones like this can get away with, you know, making a joke out of something that should not be a joke. Now, Donald Trump says something very interesting. He says, is that the one you like? And it actually connects with something that was said earlier. One second here.
The Lord is, there is liberty. And here there is Liberty College, but Liberty University.
Well, there isn't liberty because you universe, or you in a university or college that requires of you not to think for yourself and align yourself to their will.
But it is so true. You know, when you think, and that's really, is that the one? Is that the one you like?
Is that the one you like? Because I know that they not in the spirit because they pick and choose as they so please. Actually, let's go forward to this over here.
All right, so he is winning over some of the evangelical...
most favored Bible verses.
Evangelical vote, but I think he's bull about God.
I'm wondering what one or two of your most favored Bible verses are.
Well, I wouldn't want to get into it because to me that's very personal.
An Old Testament guy or a New Testament guy?
Probably equal.
See, they're making fun of him, say, of Donald Trump, saying that he's neither old nor new. He's equal, and that's true. The Bible should not be broken into pieces. Now, it's not funny to make a joke out of something that's actually true, because then people that cannot be liberty in the spirit, cannot think for themselves, will not be able to think the right conclusion, the correctness of what he said, that you don't break up the Bible in pieces, because then you play God, making God to your image and your likeness. Is that the one you like? We know that the evangelical movement likes to pick and choose what they like. So Donald Trump is pretty much in their face saying, is that the one you like? I mean, you guys pick and choose whatever you like. You should be smart enough to know that what I'm doing is what I'm doing. I'm doing what I'm doing. I'm getting my agenda across. Y'all don't have a choice. As a matter of fact, the people in the background don't even have a choice, because they're not free or in the liberty of Christ to think for themselves or do for themselves as they please, which is to do and serve the real and true God. So manifested to us in His Imperial Majesty Ali Selassie I, King of Kings of Ethiopia, conquering Lion of the Tribe of Judah, in Yeshua HaMashiach, in the Son of the Living God, Jesus Christ, some would say. Now, he says that they broke a record of attendance, and I'm not even going to play the clip. This dude, the host of the show, says that they broke it because they students and they have to attend by force. The whole, whatever they call this. So, Ina is going to have to find that probably.
Mr. King's not your 16-year-old girlfriend. What does that mean?
Well,
let me just break down that entire attendance. It's only because Liberty enrollment is up. Down that entire statement for you guys. Okay. Liberty's.
Yes, you did by quite a bit. So we'll dedicate.
The first thing he did, of course, was brag about the crowd size.
We broke the record. You know, we had the record for about 3 or 4 years the last time. And the first thing I said to Jerry and Becky when I got here, did we break the record?
They're talking about the record of attendance to whatever this is.
Record, they said, yes, you did by quite a bit. So we'll dedicate that to Martin Luther King, a great man.
Yeah, Martin Luther King is a great man because he led all the lost sheep, lost black and brown, now found sheep of Israel, to Egypt and not to Ethiopia, to the King of Kings. So he is a great man in Donald Trump's point of view because, you know, the black sheep make him a lot of money.
Dr. King, how did he get in this? What do you mean, dedicate? Dr. King's not your 16-year-old girlfriend. What does that mean? Well, let me just break down that entire statement for you guys, okay? Liberty students are required by the university to attend these rallies. So if Trump broke a record for attendance, it's only because Liberty enrollment is up.
So no such thing as Liberty and Liberty College, because they have to put up with this. They have to see this. Shalom.